Glory to the Lord Jesus, and blessings to each and everyone that is watching this video. And this is your brother Perez, and I'm here to release a few prophecies for 2025 and beyond, meaning 2025, and then some few more years after 2025. So these prophetic messages are going to be happening, especially in the time period of 2025, 2026, and 2027, if Jesus tarries to come. So I'm going to go real quick and present the prophetic messages to you. And this prophetic message is that I'm gonna present, you can pray with it. It's not everything that you have to allow to happen by itself. The prophetic messages that I'm gonna share, make sure that you pray with it. Pray with it. Pray against them, because not everything that we share, because most of them are bad, not everything that we share you have to allow to happen. No. Many of them you have to pray against it, because not every one of them will happen. Not every one of them will happen. So if you pray, not every one of them will happen if you pray. If you pray, God bless you. Not every one of them will happen if you pray. That is why I'm going to reveal the prophetic messages to you. But as I release these prophetic messages, make sure you pay very good attention. God bless you, Brother. God bless you, Brother Andrew. But as I release, God bless you, Sister Leslie. But as I release these prophetic messages, make sure you take charge and pay attention to them very well, and pray very well concerning these prophetic messages that I am releasing by the grace of God. So I kind of like was not on Facebook, and a lot of people thought that maybe I blocked them, but the reality is no, I did not block anyone. My account got deleted. I deleted my account until God had to tell me to come back himself. So sometimes we want something, but God wants something else. So it's different. But then God revealed to me these messages to come and share with you, so that you are ready and prepare for the future. Because God shows us the future for a reason. There is a reason why he shows us the future. There is a reason why the future is presented to us. And so I'm going to share this prophetic messages, and like I said earlier, the prophetic messages that I'm gonna share, pray concerning them. Pray concerning them, because you are not supposed to allow all of them to pass. So I'm gonna reveal some of the prophetic messages here, and as I release these prophetic messages, God bless you. You look so tired. We spend time with God a lot, so it's not easy to spend time with God a lot. It's not easy to spend time with God. Hallelujah. So, and I just also came from street preaching tonight, so I just came from street preaching tonight. I was street preaching from 6 p.m. to 8:15. Then after street preaching, I drove back home. I ate food that Sister Devi cooked. I ate the food. It was so nice. I ate rice and meat. It was so nice. And after that, I came into the room to spend time with God, to write down the message of 2025. And this is the first message of 2025. God is looking for the Josephs, because there is an upcoming famine coming and nobody is engaging in agriculture. People are running away from agriculture. But God says, begin to store yourselves and begin to prepare yourselves. So we need the Josephs, just like in the time of Egypt, where the Josephs prepared themselves to store food. And God says agriculture is what is gonna be booming, and many are not ready. Famine will go around the world. People are just prepared to fight for war, this and that. Even to fight for war, you have to eat. So prepare for famine coming from 2025, 2026, and 2027. That's the first prophecy. Make sure you listen to this prophecy very well. When we come out here to prophesy, it's by the grace of God. The Bible says that the Holy Spirit will tell you about the future. So I know other Christians just think Holy Spirit just make you speak in tongues after you feel good and you sleep. No, I believe in the Holy Spirit that can tell you about the future. So this Holy Spirit, when I spend time with him, he begins to tell me about the future. So I already prophesied about some of the things that will happen October, November, December. If you missed that prophecy, go back to my Facebook and watch the prophecy that I prophesied. I prophesied about Donald Trump's third attempt. You guys heard on the news a few days ago, right? I prophesied about Donald Trump's third attempt, assassination attempt. It happened just 2 days after I prophesied it. 2 days after I prophesied it, the third attempt took place. It did not take place the way I described it, but the third attempt took place 2 days after I prophesied that prophecy. Just to tell you guys, some of the things we see, it happened very quick. Some of the things we see, it takes time to happen. So this prophecy for 2025 that I am releasing right now, please make sure you are careful and pray about it and begin to invest in agriculture. I don't know, for those of you who live in city areas, you don't even have a place where you can like put your ground, like you can put ground and a farm and you can make your own, plant your own food. Texas has a big area like that. But Ohio, I believe, Ohio here has a great area like that. Maybe. But all those of you who live in New York, famine is coming. Famine is coming. It's gonna be so crazy that around the world, some people will be eating human meat. I'm telling you right now, when the time comes, you will know. And some countries will make it legal that if someone dies, like, you know, they can, you don't know what's coming to this world. When Jesus spoke that this world is an end time world, you guys think that he was joking? We are living in the end times. We are living in the last days. And Jesus said, worst is coming. Jesus said what? Worst is what? Coming. So there will be moral decay. That's prophecy number two. But let me just stick with number one. I want someone to write the title down when I release the prophecy. Thank you, Lord, for these prophetic messages. Number one, there is a global upcoming deadly famine that is coming. A global upcoming deadly famine that is coming. Remember, that is in the book of Matthew 24. I was actually reading the signs of the, I was talking about the signs of the end today on TikTok. I'll post the video on YouTube later. But I was actually talking about the signs of the end. So there is a global upcoming famine that is coming. And God is looking for Josephs. Where are the Josephs? God is looking for the Josephs. Do you know what Joseph did? During the famine, they were not lacking. Joseph made them to harvest things when there was still time and store it. They didn't eat it all. They stored it. They stored it somewhere. And then during the famine, they were now eating from there. They were not eating from there. During the famine, they were not eating from there. Someone said the famine has already started. Sir, I'm simply saying what God has shown me for 2025. Whatever you call famine in 2024 is not famine. 2025, 2026, 2027. Those will be years of famine. Remember, famine hit Egypt for how many years? 7 years. There's 3 years of famine ahead. So if you are someone who invests in agriculture in these last days, you'll be very rich. So God is looking for the Josephs. I don't know. I don't know. I really like agriculture, but I'm not gifted in that area. I'm not very gifted in that area. I really don't know. Brett Ryo, if you are watching, get ready. In Maine, we might plant some stuff over there. So there will be famine, there'll be lack of food. I mean lack of food. I'm not talking about prices going high. Prices going high is a different thing. Please, guys, do not change the message that God has given me to release. Please. Please don't put different words in my mouth. There is an upcoming deadly famine that is coming. And God is looking for the Josephs that will be able in order to protect and save the world from famine and God's people. And so the Josephs, I believe that God will give wisdom for the Josephs, because God cannot allow everybody to die of famine. Even though some people in the world will be dying of famine and some people will be eating human meat. Even though eating human meat has been existing in some countries, like Brother Bissell told me before, that in India, there are some people who eat human meat. But that thing will become viral. That thing will become viral. Some people will begin to eat human meat. I'm telling you right now. Because of famine. So, invest in agriculture if you can. I see mostly Nepali people here in Ohio. They like doing agriculture, which is like they plant a lot of pepper. That's good. But now, discover other things you can plant at the back of your house, at least, or somewhere. I don't know. God is going to give you the wisdom. But all I know is that God will create a technology for the Josephs to rise and for famine not to kill many people around the world. Jesus is coming back soon. The signs are really showing up. Prophecy number two. Should I speak this as a parable, Lord? Let me just mention, prophecy number two is for Cameroon. Cameroon is a country. The president has been in power for 40 years. But God revealed a secret that president died already. And the person that is in power has been different people that have been using his face. So the Lord. I know they may even look for me to kill me because I'm revealing this. Because many people don't know the secret. But with spiritual eyes, you see secret. So this president, if you type right now, president of Cameroon, you will discover that that president is 91 years and that he has been in power for 40 years. Even me, I used to be shocked when I hear that he's been in power for 40 years. But the reality is, this president has been announced dead over the years. And it comes as false news. Many of you will not understand because maybe you are not from Cameroon. But imagine that you hear that Joe Biden is dead. And after that, you hear that Joe Biden is alive. It's because he's dead and they brought a new face and put on someone else and the person became president and they said it is Joe Biden. I'm just giving an example. That's what's happening in Cameroon. So the president has died already long ago. But the country has been deceived that he's still alive. It is actually someone else that has his face on. And I've been doing it since 1982 until now, 2024. God says 2025, they will be exposed. And they'll be taken to the International Court of Justice. And it will bring the world's attention to the evil that is happening there. And every person in that country, that was involved in that corruption will be exposed and brought to the line. This message I'm exposing can cost my life. I'm telling you, because not many people know this thing. It's only with the eyes of the Spirit. So, this person is already dead long ago, but many of them believe that he's still alive. His face is actually being transplanted from one person to the other to lead as president of Cameroon. But that man already died truly long ago. So the secret will be exposed in 2025. Many of them will be exposed, and the Lord is about to set Cameroon free. In Jesus' name. Next prophecy. I should have given this prophecy by Proverbs. I don't know why I even mentioned the name Cameroon. Because these people might be after my life, after this prophecy. It's so evil, guys. Look at how the world is. Do you know how many years that man has been in power? 40 years, and we've been thinking it's the same person, but it's been someone else having his face. Wow, how evil is the world? How cruel is the world we're living in? Wow. So someone can literally be a different person, but having the face of that same person? This world is crazy, guys. Oh my. Meaning that a whole country can be deceived. A whole world can be deceived. What in the world? Next prophecy. Warning to those who smoke weed. Warning to those who smoke weed and smoke any form of drug. Because instant death will come February, from February and March 2025. If you know anybody that is smoking weed, it's time to stop. listen. Or else, many people will stop it by force in 2025. Because it will kill many people. For some reason, in 2025, smoking will start killing people. Many will die. Many. It will make young people to be so scared. Let me tell you the signs. It will start when? January? No, it will start February. February 2025. Many people smoking will begin to die. So if you know anyone smoking, warn them now to stop it. Send this video to them. Share this video to them. want them now to do what? To stop it. Next year, February and March, many should think twice before smoking weed or any kind of drug, because instant death shall be registered to those who engage in it. And this is what will happen to them. Bleeding before they die. Bleeding through the nostrils. Instant suffocation. And vomiting blood. It will damage their lungs. And they will have heartbeat issues. For now, the grace of God is still there for you to repent and really cry to God and say, God, help me. Or else, you that is saying it's difficult to stop, you will stop it by force in February. Because the way you'll be seeing people dying, you'll be like, oh, I'm the next. I'm telling you right now, we're living in the last days. Strange things will be happening, guys. Strange things will be happening. It will lead to kidney failure. I'm telling you right now, many things will be happening. I know these days people have been smoking weed and different things. Nothing is happening here and there. But for some reason, 2025, something will begin to happen to people who are smoking them. I really feel sad. You know, I love people in their weakness. If I see someone who is weak, I'll still love them. It is not me. I'm just sharing what is in the spirit. You understand? It's just because the world is reaching a different type of level now. And Christ is about to come back. He's trying to warn the world in different ways. But sadly, many people, some people will die next year in February and March. If you stop smoking, I believe that God's mercy will be upon you. But if February catches you, February and March catches you, that you are still addicted to your smoking, you may be part of those that will disappear. It will happen worldwide. America will record cases too. So we need to pray. We need to pray for God's mercy. We need to pray for God's mercy. Remember those who are smoking. Weed, cocaine. Remember them in your prayer. I love them. But you know, sometimes God does things for a reason. Don't smoke. If you know anybody, warn them. Tell them to think twice before smoking it. Because there's a prayer I'll pray here at the end for those who smoke. Because I can pray for people, and when they put smoke in their mouth, it will not taste good anymore for them. And they will throw it away. So I will assist them and be praying for them. I will pray for those people right here. So if you know anybody that is smoking, whether it's weed, whether it's cocaine, whatever it is, someone is maybe asking, what about vaping? I don't know. God just told me anyone that's smoking weed and any form of drug should be careful in February and March, because I saw many of them dying. And what they were doing before they died is they had bleeding, instant bleeding. They were bleeding from the nose, instant suffocation, vomiting blood, and then shortness of breath, and boom, they're gone. So I will advise anyone that is smoking, please, it's time to let it go. Like, sometimes God will have to make you repent by force, and that's the sad thing. Like, please, I love you, and Jesus loves you, but please, it's time to repent. It's time to believe in the power of God and repent from smoking. How many of you saw the third attempt of Donald Trump's assassination? I released that prophecy and it came to pass in 2 days. 2 days after it happened, they tried to kill Trump a third time. Next. The fate of many shall grow cold. 2025, 2026, and 2027. Lack of betrayal and lack of trust will also grow. There will be cameras that are invented that you can put on the hair of people, in shoes, in caps, on jackets, in bags, and people will have this camera everywhere that will expose the secret of their friends, and it will cause relationships to break, it will cause marriages to break, because there'll be some little cameras. I don't know how little it will be. It was so little, but if you put it on someone's shoe like this, you put it on someone's shoe, it can be so little that even if you put it on someone's shoe and the person puts the shoe like this in the room, maybe like this, the camera will be watching you from the shoe, watching everything you are doing. They can watch you from their phone. So that thing will start going viral from next year, 2025, 2026, and 2027. That technology will go viral and it will destroy a lot of relationships. It will destroy a lot of marriages. It would destroy a lot of trust. And it will be so destructive that some people would download camera tracking devices so that they can see where those cameras are. The camera tracking devices can tell you where the camera is. So it will be so bad that people will be download. It will be so bad. Like people can literally put camera on your hair. Maybe while you are sleeping, even if you wash your hair, it will still be there. They can put, it will be so little, but you can see anything and hear anything. People will be invading people's spaces, people's business with those little cameras. Cameras will no more be very big like you guys see every time. It will be so little, so little. Maybe it's in our homes already. Like some people were saying that the TV is watching me. Like TV is watching everybody at home. Maybe that's true, guys. Maybe that's just a secret they've never told you guys. Who knows? Maybe in your phone. You never know. Maybe in your phone they're watching you guys. They can hear you. You never know this world. That's crazy. We never know. If they are hearing my conversations, then then I'm going to finish them. So yeah, that in technology will increase in 2025, 2026, and 2027. It will be so great and it will destroy many marriages. It will destroy many relationships because secrets will be discovered. Secrets will be discovered. People will use it against each other. Husband will use it against wife. Wife will use it against husband. Sister will use it against brother. Friend will use it against friend. And it will cause chaos in the world. It will be all around the world. Everywhere. It shall destroy many people. People can even put it on your back. Your backpack. They can just hang it there a little bit. It will be so little that you can't realize that it's a camera. Yeah, they can put it on your hair, they can put it on your clothing, on your shoe. Yeah. Okay, next prophecy. Next prophecy. Another pandemic shall come, but it can be stopped. Listen to it again. Another pandemic shall come, but it can be stopped. This pandemic will be more deadlier than the COVID-19, Remember, I said these prophecies are from 2025, 2026, 2027. This one, you may not see it happening in 2025, but from 2026, or maybe ending 2025. This pandemic, it will affect people through the mouth, through their eyes, through their ears. It will even make some people not to hear anymore, to be deaf. I'm telling you right now. And people will be talking by sign languages. Because even when you open your mouth, it's already gone to someone else. Just opening your mouth, even with your mask. Even with the mask on. That's why God is revealing it now, so that the world can prepare. It shall affect trees. This other one shall affect trees. Trees will just be falling on their own. Big trees. It just be as if the tree burned from the inside and then boom, the tree falls. That's why I'm telling you that one, even to affect people, they will be talking by sign languages. The Bible says in the end times there'll be pestilences. There'll be earthquakes. There'll be pestilences. There'll be famine. That's the verse that we are in right now. So that can be stopped. Remember, the prophecy says it can be stopped. It can be stopped. It can be stopped. So God is showing it in details now because it's deadlier than the COVID. But at that time, that's why it's good for Trump to be president, because at that time, he will listen to advice from men of God around the world, and they will pray towards this thing and allow this thing to cool down or stuff like that. All right. Now, I also saw a sickness coming to the LGBTQ community next year. I love them. You guys already know. I love people. I love sinners. If someone sin, I still love the person. I'm not going to bash the person down, because I used to be a sinner too. So Jesus Christ loves sinners. If you don't love sinners, you cannot evangelize. You cannot win souls. That's why you see not everybody is winning souls, because not everybody really loves sinners. So, but the thing is, there's a sickness that will be hitting the LGBT, specifically people from the LGBTQ community. And it will cause many of the LGBTQ to sutasute, to die, sadly. And it will cause fear among them. I saw a sickness specifically attacking them. It was attacking their sexual organ. It was getting rotten. I'm telling you right now. So be careful. If you are LGBTQ 2025 moving forward, be careful. Careful. Call on God, he will help you. Call on God. So that will happen too. I also saw moral decay. Moral decay. I saw many pornography industries were introduced next year, 2025. And sadly, many youths were trapped in it. And their destiny was destroyed. Many. And you discover that, I know some people don't want to hear about this, but we have to talk about it. And if you discover very well, as a youth, for example, if you indulge in those activities, you cannot be energized for the kingdom of God. You'll be weak every time. You'll not be able to do anything for the kingdom of God. So please be careful, because next year it will double. there will be more pornography into institutions, more pornography industries around the world. Around the world. And in Japan, I don't want to say certain things. In Japan, people were walking around saying, for example, that we need men. You see young, beautiful women walking on the street saying that we want fantasy. I'm telling you, moral decay will increase next year, 2025. From 2025 moving forward. Because we're living in the last days. It will increase. So you have to be very careful about 2025, 2026 moving forward. And concerning President Trump, I and Brett Ryo will be going there today on the 21st of October so that we go and pray for the president. I was invited to the 11th Faith Leaders Meeting in North Carolina on the 21st. That'll be my first time to see the president face to face, but you know, we will pray for him over there. But for some reason, I was invited to go there. So Brett Ryo is next to some people who is closer to President Joe Biden, not President Trump. And so Brett Ryo talked to them about me, and they invited me to there. So I'll be going there on the 21st, and we'll pray for Trump. And Trump is the one that is chosen to win the election. God has chosen Trump to win the election. So God has chosen Trump. God has chosen Trump. And the only thing I will say is this. If they postpone the election, know that Kamala Harris will get it. So pray that they don't postpone the election. Because if they postpone the election, she will manipulate it. And she will get it. And if Kamala Harris becomes president, prepare for the rapture. I'm telling you right now. I'm telling you right now. If Kamala Harris becomes president, get ready for the rapture. But if Trump becomes president, 8 years of mercy will be given to the United States. 8 years of mercy. God will have mercy on America for 8 years. But if Kamala Harris goes on power, I'm not saying this for anything, because I've seen a lot of people who call themselves prophet and they say, Kamala Harris, we're supposed to put her there. You don't know what you're talking about, prophet. What kind of prophet are you? Are you really hearing God's voice? God's choice is Donald Trump. But you are going by the color because you are black skin. Because you are dark skin, you say, oh, we choose Kamala Harris. No, don't go by the skin. Go by the spirit. God's choice is Donald Trump. I'm telling you guys right now. I don't care who you're going to vote. I don't vote. But some of you all here do vote. But I'm telling you God's choice right now. If you go and vote Kamala Harris, that's on your own. God's choice is Donald Trump. God's choice is Donald Trump. God will have mercy on America again if Donald Trump wins. But I saw a lot of protest. The red and the blues, they were protesting. There was an unrest. There was a protest, and they tried to postpone the election. If they postpone the election, Kamala Harris will press those buttons. Pew, 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 pew. And then she'll get to power. I'm telling you right now. Remember, it looked like Donald Trump was winning in 2020. And then somehow Joe Biden won. So Trump is the one that is chosen by God to win this election. Trump is the one, is God's choice, chosen to win the election. He may not be perfect. He may have many wives. He may have done many things that's wrong. But God is with him. And God has chosen that man. God has chosen that man in order to be the president of America. He is God's choice. And so, the satanic forces in America are fighting. I released some secrets last time. I released some secret last time, and then I'm gonna release again. The first assassination attempt, the evil government was included inside. I'm not gonna expose everything, because like I told you, as I'm releasing these prophecies, people are gonna start looking for me to kill me. So I don't wanna expose much. Things that I know, I'm just gonna keep it to myself. Second assassination attempt of Trump, the lady was there. She was the one who I speak in parables. The lady was the one who sponsored the second attempt. But this third attempt, none of them sponsored this third assassination attempt. Even all of them, they are surprised. They're like, who did this other third one? Who tried to kill Donald Trump on this other third one? So all their plan failed. That is why I believe that God allowed Trump all these things to fail, because Trump is supposed to be president. The only thing we should be praying about is pray that they don't postpone the election. Because if they postpone the election, I'm telling you right now, that woman, Kamala Harris, she knows the buttons to press. The same buttons they press on Trump in 2024, they will begin to press it again. And I saw protest. I saw racism increase in America. I saw white fight black. I saw black fight white. I saw white fight brown. I saw brown fight white. I'm telling you right now, racism next year in America will be high. But if you're a true Christian, you will know that you're not supposed to be a racist. And in fact, a true Christian is not a racist, because God is not a racist. But that spirit will be so strong. So please, let's continue to pray for our president, Donald Trump. Donald Trump will be put there as president. He is the one that is chosen. He is the one that is supposed to be elected. Donald Trump is the one. Donald Trump is the one. Kamala Harris, I know she has her own flaws, but she's not the one that is chosen. But please, remember, I said this one thing. If the election is postponed, start getting ready for the rapture. Because this woman will come with the beast system. That's why we're going to pray for Trump, so that his winning stays a win. Because Trump will always, he will win by election. But if Kamala Harris tries to, if the election is postponed, Kamala Harris will win by corruption. Trump will win by election, but if it is postponed, Kamala Harris will win by corruption. So pray for them. The demons don't like when I expose these things. All football updates. Why do you believe that? All right. So that is what I can say about who's going to be president. I already told you your choice. The American choice that has been chosen by God. His name is Donald Trump. He's the one that is chosen by God to sound his trumpet, to finish his mission. Let him finish what he came to do. Allow Trump to finish sounding his trumpet. He is not done sounding his trumpet. When he's done, he will go. Allow him to finish sounding his trumpet. He's the one that is chosen for God this season and this hour to save America. God will pass through him to save America. And there is also something like the rapture will begin next year, but the first phase of rapture is called death, where you just see people will just disappear. There'll be strange death next year. Like, you can just be talking to someone today, and the next hour you hear that the person is dead. That's the strange type of death that'll be happening next year. It'll be like a first type of level of rapture. I don't know how to explain that kind of death. But people will be so healthy, so good. And then you just talk to someone, and on the phone, after 1 hour, you discover that the person is dead. You'll be like, what is going on? So that's the kind of rapture that'll be happening from the year of 2025. So stay strong in Jesus' name. Next thing, pray against poisoning of fruit. When you are buying fruit, cucumber, apple, oranges. Pray for it, because I saw a lot of those products being poisoned. I'm not saying you can't eat it, but as a Christian, when you pray on something, it becomes sanctified. And when it is sanctified, you can eat it. The Bible says poison will not kill you. But if you don't pray on it and you eat, you're going to have stomach issue. And it can destroy some of your organs. Because most of these things that are imported, and including banana too, you need to pray on them before you eat. Remember, pray on them before you eat. Some of you have probably been having stomach issues because you have not prayed on those fruit. They are poisoned. Most of them are poisoned. That's the evil of the world. Yeah, they are poisoned. And so pray for God's guidance before you take a vaccine next year, 2025. Because there'll be a certain type of vaccine that will come out when people will take it. After a few months, it will destroy them. So please be careful. These last days, there's so much deception. Just like I told you about my country, Cameroon, that has been deceived for 40 years. We were all thinking that it was that one man that was in power. But it's been different people in power, guys. With different faces. With the same face. But how is that possible? This world is the world of Satan, guys. This world belongs to Satan. I don't even know how they do those things, to be honest. Like, imagine you see another person with the face of Perez. But it is not me. That's crazy, right? Is it cloning or something? Is it cloning or what? That's weird. So be very careful. Next year, 2025. This is just part one for the prophecies of 2025. When God reveals me part two, I will come again and I will share them with you. If God reveals part two, I'll come again and I'll share them with you. But the one that really hurt me was the one of smoking. Those who are smoking, they were dying in February and March. Hallelujah. God reveals to redeem, right? I'm not trying to put fear on anybody. Do you think I want people to die? No. But this is what is happening. Do you know those who are after my life? People are after me to kill me because of some of the messages that I reveal. That's why some secrets I keep it to myself. I'm telling you the truth. Some secrets I keep it to myself. So I use proverbs to speak sometimes, because if I voice out certain things, they're just going to... So the life of prophets are very in danger. So that's why you see me, I like focusing more on winning souls. That one gives me peace. It doesn't bring me much trouble. But when I come out like this and I reveal secrets like this, demons start getting mad and they try to look at me to kill me. But one day, if someone kills me, just know that I'm going to be with God in heaven. Because at the end of the day, people are always mad when you reveal secrets, and they will try to get you if you are revealing too much secret. I know all those who tried to kill Trump the first attempt. Those who planned it, I know all of them. But I don't have physical proofs, but I know them spiritually. I know those who planned the second one spiritually, but the third one, nobody planned it. It was just that guy on its own that went to shoot. So the update I'll be giving you about Trump will be coming up. Just get ready. I'll keep coming to tell you. If anything changes, and if it is the woman that will finally take it, I will tell you. If anything changes, I will tell you. Because prophecy can change. You understand? Especially concerning these elections. Because either way, whoever wins, prophecy will be fulfilled. But it is God's will for Trump to win, or else America will no longer be a superpower. Many countries will laugh at America. Many countries will mock at America. Saudi Arabia is already laughing. Russia is already laughing. Russia is supporting Kamala Harris. If you don't know, I have to tell you right now. Russia is already supporting Kamala Harris. Dubai is supporting Arab countries, Muslims, they are supporting Kamala Harris. You know why? They want America to fall. So God wants to use Donald Trump. I know people may say, oh, he hates immigrants, this and that. Everybody has flaws. But that's God's chosen one, guys. He got a role. He got a reign. So if you are here and you are watching this video and you're a Christian, my advice to you, make the right choice. For those of you who are voting, make the right choice. In Jesus' mighty name. Father, thank you for tonight. And I want to pray, if you are here and you smoke, I want to pray for you. So that taste of smoke will not be good in your mouth anymore. If you are here and you smoke, I want to pray for you. Make sure you watch this prophecy over and over and share this prophecy to meet as many people as you can. I'll try to put this prophecy on YouTube. Share it to many people as you can. All right, let me pray for I don't want to share about Putin and the rest because very soon that man is leaving. He has a problem with his heart. Very soon he's leaving the world. Including the judgment of God is going to hit North Korea. That president. But I don't want to prophesy about them right now. I'll leave them for now. There's certain things we can't say everything. So I'll leave them for now. But I want to pray for those who smoke. Please, I want to pray for you. What I saw next year is terrible. It's terrible. So let's pray. And if you know anybody that is smoking in your family, remember them in prayer. Remember them in prayer. February and March is not a good month. Death, 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 untimely death. It will scare a lot of young people. I'm telling you, I saw a lot of young people stopping smoking by force. Like they felt like smoking, but they were like, I'm not trying to die. I'm telling you right now, it was so strong that even young people were running away from smoking by force because they were seeing the death rate. And it went around on the news. It went viral. When that time comes, you will know that Jesus revealed this to us and we spoke about it. The Bible says the Holy Spirit, He will guide you in all truth, but the Holy Spirit will tell you about the future. So the Holy Spirit speaks about the future so that we can prepare. The Bible says prophecy is to exhort. Prophecy is to encourage, to edify. So this prophecy is not to build any fear, but to build you to be prepared for what's coming in the future. Hallelujah. So let's pray for anyone that is smoking. If you know anybody that is smoking weed or any form of drugs, please pray for them. Because even I was with some youths down today and they were dancing with me and I was just loving them, even though they are not perfect, you know, they are not living for God and stuff. I told them they were singing for Jesus and most of them were smoking weed. And I was like, yo. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, please, if you know anybody that is smoking weed, let's pray for them. I threw some tarot cards and Godion in the trash. Okay, that's good. Okay, let's pray. If you know anybody that is smoking, let's pray for them. And make sure you forward this video to them. I know someone, especially those people who are going to say, forget about this guy. He doesn't know what he's saying. If that person says that, I just pray God forgive them because what I saw, all right? Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for this person that has been smoking for a long time. And you are the chain breaker and the one who breaks addiction. Lord, we do not want untimely death to happen to them in February and March. And so right now, Lord, I pray that you set them free from this addiction. Set them free from this addiction. Even for the LGBTQ, I pray that you set them free before any form of sickness begin to hit them. I pray for these people that are smoking, that Lord, you have mercy on them. They don't know any better. Lord, help them in this the addiction. Set them free, Lord. May your name be glorified. May your name be magnified. May your name be exalted. In Jesus' mighty name. in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I pray from today that as you take that smoke to smoke, it will taste very bad and you will throw it away forever. You will renounce it. Now, speak this after me. Say, Dear Jesus, I renounce this smoking habit. I renounce weed. I renounce drugs. From today, I am free. In Jesus' name, amen. You are free in Jesus' name. I pray you are free in Jesus' name. Some of you from today, when you taste it, it's going to feel nasty. It's going to be nasty. It's not going to be sweet anymore. You will even text me to testify. You'll be like, yo, brother Perez, it's nasty. So, thank you, Jesus, for this message tonight. If God reveals more messages, I will come and share. But I already revealed about New York. The Statue of Liberty is going to fall. And it's going to be a sign that New York will be destroyed. And God said those who are in New York and they have a weak faith, they should begin to evacuate the city. Begin to run out of New York, move to a different state. Because that's the state on the list that will be destroyed. In the coming future, very destroyed. So if you're investing a lot of things in New York, it's not time to invest a lot of things in New York. And California is on the list. What California is going through is not really destruction yet. But California will be destroyed after New York. And idols will be falling in different states. You just begin to see. Even in Brazil, I prophesied about those things. The Statue of Liberty will collapse. There will be collapse of idols of Mary. Because God was showing that in the vision that those idols of Mary is the Queen of Heaven. An idol that people worship. But in the physical, people say, oh, it's Mary. It's Mary. But in the spiritual, it's different, guys. Hallelujah. Okay, God bless you guys and stay blessed. Please pray over this prophecy. And for those of you who do agriculture, please go back and listen to the first prophecy. I prophesied about famine that is coming, a deadly famine that's coming. And God is looking for the Josephs, those who are going to be able to preserve the body of Christ, to protect the body of Christ. Whether you're going to open a storehouse for those of you who are very, very, very rich, do good to open a great storehouse and maybe store a bunch of food there. That can help some people during the time of famine. All right, and God bless you guys. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Right now, I will go offline and I'll be updating you guys in case God reveals me more things. Stay blessed and have a wonderful night or morning wherever you are. In Jesus' name, Shalom.